As producers, we often work with supervisors and leads to assign tasks to artists. While some tasks may already be in Shotgun, others may be one-offs which need to be created on the fly. In this topic, we'll cover task templates first, and then the anatomy of a task, and lastly, creating tasks on the fly for a couple of common workflows. Aside from one-off tasks that are more unpredictable, we have a known set of tasks on our signal project that need to happen with each entity, like on shots or assets or any other entity that has to-dos. For our assets, we have a known list of four tasks that typically make up an asset's to-do list. So let's head to our task templates page to create this list. Task templates can be found via the admin dropdown. Here, we'll see a list of task templates that are typically grouped by entity, but we can adjust the grouping and sorting if we need to. In this case, we want to group by project and then by entity. Now, we can see a list of which task templates already exist for our signal project, and we can create a new task template for our prop assets. But first, we notice the example asset task template that Shotgun ships with. So we open it up in a new tab so that we can refer to it. It actually looks very similar to what we need to create, so it'll be easier for us to duplicate it and then restrict it to our signal project once we make a couple of updates. So we right-click on the template and select Duplicate Selected Template and Tasks. We'll rename the copy and call it VFX Asset Task Template, and we'll restrict it to the signal project. Note that if there is no project restriction, the task template is available to all projects. We'll open it up in a new tab and we'll make the updates we need. Before we apply our task template to entities, let's examine the field traits on a task that Shotgun ships with. We'll breeze past some of these, but make important notes on others. Note that you may have more fields created on tasks than what we cover, since they may vary per studio based on customizations. Let's start by exposing all the columns via the Fields dropdown, Configure Columns, Toggle All. The task name can be a brief description of the to-do. A pipeline step is like a department. There can be many tasks within one pipeline step. For instance, we have two tasks listed in the art pipeline step, concept and archive. These are the two to-dos that need to happen from our art department before modeling can start. The status defines the state of the task. The status can be updated as the artist works on that task. A task can be assigned to a person, people, or a group. Tasks have a start date and a due date, which will be visible throughout Shotgun, whether in My Tasks or on a schedule page. The duration and bid fields are similar. The duration is the length of the task, which can change over time, while the bid typically remains the same. If we were to add a default bid and duration to the tasks in our task template, we can do this so that all of the tasks already have this information when we apply them to assets. Time logged will show me a sum of the time logged against that task, and it will also allow me to add time by clicking the plus icon while hovering over it, or see the time logs against each task by clicking the info button. The time logged percent of bid and the time logged over under bid will show me calculations based on the time logged against each of the bids. We'll cover this in more detail in the tracking bids against time log topic. The sort order will help me sort tasks easily in the task template, so we can apply upstream and downstream dependencies. To apply upstream dependencies, we make sure tasks are sorted in order, and then select all, right-click, select dependencies, and link selected. Then we'll notice that all of the upstream and downstream dependency fields are filled in correctly. The inventory date shows the date a task can be started based on upstream dependencies. If a task is pinned, the inventory date lets us know what date Shotgun would use as the start date without the pin. We can choose to pin any task where we don't want those task dates to update automatically. This keeps the connections between tasks, but takes the task off autopilot. We can pin tasks by checking this box or by right-clicking on the task and selecting Dependencies, Pin Selected Tasks. We'll cover more about pinning in the scheduling with the Gantt chart topic. The The Gantt bar color defines the color of the taskbar that will show up on the task Gantt. By default, it will be set to match the color of the pipeline step. This can always be updated to make certain tasks stand out when needed. We'll also cover more about colors in the scheduling with the Gantt chart topic. We can add a milestone like an art delivery or client review to our schedule without making it a task. Once we check the milestone box, it'll be apparent on the schedule and will just require a start date. These schedule milestones are independent from the project timeline created milestones that can be overlaid on the Gantt. Some of these fields may be required upon creation of a task, and that's all configurable through the form if you have the proper permissions to do so. When we create a new task on the fly, we open the form and we can configure it to include required fields. The required fields will be required by everyone, not just us, when we make the change to the form. These required fields can also be configured per project, which will be covered in another topic. Now that we have an understanding of all the fields on tasks, let's finalize our asset task template for our signal project and apply it to all of our prop assets in the project, keeping in mind that these assets haven't had any tasks created for them yet, since I've gone ahead and cleaned up the sample tasks that were created so we can start with a blank slate. So let's head to our Signal Project Asset page and expose the Task Template column. Next, we'll select all of the props listed under the prop grouping, right-click on the Task Template column, and select Edit Task Template on Selected, and we'll select the VFX Asset Task Template from the dropdown and save. Now, when we refresh, all of the tasks will exist just as we made them in the Task Template. When we head to our schedule page, they'll exist there as well, grouped by asset. Let's say we need to make updates to this task template later on. We can do so by heading to the task template page again and making the adjustments necessary. Note that task template adjustments are additive, so we can only add new tasks to entities the task templates are already linked to, but not subtract or edit existing tasks that are already linked to those entities. Let's modify the milestone name and then add a new QC task. Then, let's head back to the main task template page. Right-click on the task template and select Update Entities with New Tasks. We select our signal project, update, and now we can see at the top that the 7 assets these task templates were linked to have been updated with a new QC task. So let's head to the task page and review the updates. We can see that the QC tasks have been added to these assets. Awesome! We also see that the review milestone we updated on the existing task that was in the task template has not been updated. And that's because the task already existed and that field data will not be overwritten. But, in the future, when we link the task template to assets, that information will be incorporated accordingly. Now, let's switch gears from assets to shots and imagine that some time has passed. While we were in dailies this morning, we had a number of shots we finaled pending tech and paint fixes. Since the tech fix tasks have not been created yet on these shots, we'll go ahead and create them now on our Shots page within the Comp Pipeline step, since that's our workflow. First, we filter by the shots that we want to add tech fixes to. Then, we'll select the shots and right-click in the Comp Pipeline step, final the comp tasks in bulk, and any leftover tasks, like this lighting one. Then, we'll select Add Task to Selected, and name it Paint Fix, and assign them to the Comp Fix group. Lastly, we'll keep these shots selected, right-click on the Status column, and bulk update these shot statuses to Final Pending Fix. Our tech fix coordinator has a page filter set up on the task page that he monitors for tasks assigned to the comp fix group, and he will assign these tasks to individuals and schedule them out. Then, these artists will see tasks assigned to them in their My Tasks. Now we have an efficient way of identifying all the shots that are final pending any tech fixes and can keep track of those one-off tasks that were made more on the fly. But before leaving for the day, we notice that we still have a list of shots that we need to enter kickbacks for. This time, we head to our task page to show another way of quickly creating ad hoc tasks, and start creating kickbacks and linking them to shots. We create a task called Kickback and enter our description, decrease the rock spin by 50%. Link it to the shot in animation pipeline step. Assign it to the animation group. Make sure that our kickback status is selected, a status that we customized in our project tracking settings. And then we hold down the Alt-Option key on our keyboard and create our first kickback while keeping the values and creating the next one, since these kickbacks are similar in nature and we just need to update the shot links. Then, once we're finished with the last kickback, we can call it a night. Aside from the more workflow-specific ways of adding tasks that we've covered, there are also a few other ways that tasks can be added to Shotgun. By navigating to the detail page of an entity, like Shots, in our project, we can add a task right from the activity stream, or we can select the task tab and create a new task from there. We can add a task directly from My Tasks. Just remember that we'll have to populate the link field since we're not in the context of a specific asset or a shot in My Tasks. We can also import tasks in bulk in a similar way that we covered in the importing topic. From a task page, select the More button and then follow the importer's instructions. In the next topic, we'll cover how to view tasks in a more digestible way in the pipeline step columns.